After Disney's acquisition of Fox, the rumor mill has been active concerning the possible development of several new series or even films set in the Alien universe. In this video, I'd like to dive into the lore behind what I believe to be one of the most iconic creations to come from this classic franchise, the fearsome and mighty Xenomorph Queen. Physically, the Queen is perhaps the most unique of all known Xenomorph casts. While their height varies, they will typically stand at around 15 feet, but are capable of reaching a height of up to 40. The Queen's features are also quite pronounced. They possess a large, crown-like carapace on their heads, which serves as an armored protection for their face and mouth, which can be retracted into it. It is thought that this head crest serves as a sensory antenna, allowing her to sense thermal, biochemical, and bioelectrical signals. While queens have been noted to instruct their brood via audible screeches, it is thought that their primary means of communication is more complex, possibly involving ultrasound or the release of pheromones. It has been proposed by Weyland-Yutani researchers that queens and their offspring share a bioelectrical hive consciousness, evidenced by the fact that queens seem to remain in almost constant contact with their brood, able to communicate with them across significant distances or through considerable obstructions. Other notable physical characteristics which distinguish a queen xenomorph are their double-jointed hind legs, two sets of dorsal tubes, two pairs of arms, one large and one small, six-digit hands, and an extra armored shell located on their chest in the form of another carapace. While tending to be black or black-blue in coloration, occasionally these creatures have been found to vary quite noticeably in color, perhaps being linked to their age. The Queen's outer mesoskeleton is so resilient that it is capable of repelling sustained automatic gunfire, with only armor-piercing ammunition able to penetrate it. Although rare, Xenomorph Queens are capable of engaging in combat, serving as formidable opponents. They are quite hardy, able to sustain massive physical trauma while still being able to incapacitate nearby enemies. It's been noted that queens possess extreme muscle density, capable of tearing synthetics in two with just their hands. They are also quite fast for their size, having been clocked running at speeds of up to 25 miles or 40 kilometers per hour. Typically, she will act as a stationary egg layer within a hive, possessing a large egg sac called an ovipositor, which renders her immobile. When laying, she will typically produce up to 15 eggs per hour. The hive is tended to by workers, with the queen relying on Praetorian and drone xenomorphs to perform any defensive or offensive tasks. In the event that she is facing imminent danger, she can detach herself from her ovipositor and regrow it again at a later time, although this process is apparently quite painful. Usually, there is only a single queen present in any xenomorph populace. However, on occasion, it is possible for multiple queens to come into contact with each other. This leads to a conflict with the ultimately dominant queen rising to serve as empress, ruling over any other queens located within her domain. These creatures are incredibly long-lived, with some estimated to have survived for tens of thousands of years. In certain conditions, queens are able to hibernate and suspend their metabolism as a means to further extend their lifespan. While intellectual traits are present in virtually all xenomorphs, the queen's intelligence and observational learning abilities are greater than most. They have been known to operate man-made machinery and are able to understand and interpret human actions and behaviors. This intelligence was showcased when the first queen on LV-426 ordered her drones to back off when Ripley threatened to destroy her eggs. Their ability to interact and negotiate or bargain with humans in this way serves as evidence of their advanced intellect. Although they often display violent and hostile tendencies, a queen's actions or even inaction is typically motivated by a strong instinct to care for and protect their offspring at all costs, especially their unborn eggs. The ability to threaten a queen with the destruction of her eggs can be used as leverage against her in order to force her cooperation. However, the destruction of a queen's nest can drive her into a vengeful rage. In the novelization of Aliens written by the legendary Alan Dean Foster, A theory is posited by Bishop that, similar to how honeybee queens are created, the introduction of royal jelly at the egg stage may lead to the creation of a queen. Royal jelly, also known as alien jelly, is a potent, transformative substance produced by a xenomorph queen. This results in the creation of a royal facehugger, capable of implanting a special queen embryo into a host, as well as an additional normal embryo into a second host, so that the queen would have a drone to protect it during the critical early stages of its life. While the royal facehugger was originally in the third Alien film, it was removed from the theatrical release. As a result, the Alien novels and the Alien vs. Predator video game series developed their own method of creating the queen. In their version, a queen would evolve from lower xenomorphs, molting from Praetorians, which themselves evolved from drones. In climbing the xenomorph hierarchy, as mentioned previously, queens are subordinate to the xenomorph empress, who are in turn subordinate to a queen mother, also referred to as mother queens or hive mothers. Queen mothers serve as the supreme controlling force of the species, and have only been found on Xenomorph Prime, also known as the Hive World. Throughout the history of the Alien franchise, the involvement of a queen in the Xenomorph lifecycle was not always intended. In the initial cut of Ridley Scott's 1979 film Alien, the living bodies of a Xenomorph's victims are slowly mutated into eggs, thus bypassing the need for a queen. However, for reasons of pacing, the scene showing this stage of the alien's life cycle was cut. This allowed Aliens director James Cameron to introduce a concept for a massive mother alien that he had initially conceived in a speculative screenplay called Mother. The queen's inclusion in his film then formed the new accepted basis for the alien's life cycle. The lore behind the queen is such that, in comparison to most other xenomorph casts, she stands out as one of the smartest and strongest of them all. However, many fans feel that given her superior status in the established lore, her on-screen appearances throughout the franchise have not quite lived up to her reputation. This stems from the fact that she gets taken down cleanly in basically every appearance she has. While there are many reasons why Alien stands out as my favorite film in the franchise by far, Ripley's iconic showdown with the Queen is definitely a big one. That being said, if the team producing any future Alien projects chose to turn up the dial in their presentation of the Queen, showcasing her superior intelligence, hardiness, and ferocity, it's safe to say that would go a long way with many fans who want to see her get the respect that she deserves. But I'm curious to know what you think about the lore behind the Alien Queen. Do you think it takes away from the horror element of the franchise to have her serve as a hive mind? Or do you think that the Queen's inclusion is a net positive for the franchise? And let me know what you think of this formidable Xenomorph's on-screen appearances. Would you like to see her truly live up to her superior reputation in a future project? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. I hope you enjoyed this video. Leave a like if you did, and be sure to subscribe for more sci-fi and fantasy news and lore. Thank you all so much for your support, and as always, have a very nerdy day.